Fantastic. Thank you. I'm excited about this song, Undivided. It's going to be on Tim's upcoming deluxe version of Here on Earth. Obviously, we got to set the scene of how this whole thing came together. And I'll start with you, Tyler, because you're writing this song on the bus. You're quarantining, not able to go to the CMAs. Of all the songs that you could write, and I'm sure you wrote other songs while you were on there, why specifically this song? Where did it come from? And then how do you decide in that moment, Tim's my guy for this song?
Yeah, man. I think just, you know, really being, spending some time alone on the bus and just, you know, taking some time to soak up this year and where we're at as a culture and as a country and as a society and all the things going on in the news and everything. It was just sort of inundating me. And I was just sort of, you know, how can I channel this into something that has meaning and purpose? And honestly, I can't take much credit. It was one of those times where sometimes a song falls out of the sky, as we say, and I just feel like it's God-given, and you're just like, whoa, this song just hit me, and wow, what a gift. That's how this song was. You know, it felt very easy to write. It kind of just fell out, and as soon as I was finished, you know, I was thinking of Tim most of the time I was writing the song, thinking, man, this feels like something that could be really special, and, you know, I definitely want to show this on Tim, and, you know, as soon as we did, fortunately, he was into it, and, you know, we connected pretty quickly and decided, let's do this thing. And Tim was the one that inspired. We need to get this thing out now. This feels like a song that's perfect for this time. Basically, how fast can we turn it around? And so that was also a fun a fun challenge. It doesn't happen every day. So as a songwriter and as an artist, it's just a huge honor to be able to write this song with my buddy Chris Locke, and to be able to who made the track, and you know, to be able to do it with Tim is just incredible.
And so, Tim, from your perspective, I mean, you're the most played country artist since the 90s. You get to be really selective about what you do, and I'm sure you do get pitched a lot of songs. Why, when you heard this song, did you go, yep, we got to do this, and we got to do this right now?
Well, first off, I'm a fan of Tyler, not only as a musician, but as a person. He's a really great guy. And when this song came to me personally, it hit me as something I needed to hear, something that really set me in a mood to think about myself and what am I doing and how am I behaving and how am I acting. And I think it at music at its best can be a balm for the soul. And I think that this is one of those songs that when you hear it, that's what it feels like to you. It's a balm. And to have the opportunity to record this song and for him to ask me to be a part of it, I felt grateful and honored. And I felt like it was, like he said, I felt like it was a song that needed to be heard now. Not to in a preachy way to anybody, but sort of in a way to, you know, go look in the mirror and see what you can do for yourself to make yourself look at your better angels and cause some concentric circles around the people who love you. And maybe that'll cause them to look in the mirror and look at things a different way as well.
I think it's really well said. My 7.5-year-old is starting to really get into country music, and he's listening to the words of songs, which is really fun for me because obviously I'm a fan myself. And I told him last night, I said, there's a song for everything, buddy. Like whatever it is that you're going through, there's a song for that. And I think that that's what this song is for, what the world's going through right now, especially, you know, the things that we saw on TV last week. And so I wonder if you guys, if you've got someone who's listening to this song for the first time, maybe it's in the car, maybe they got headphones on like I do, and they're listening to the words for it for the first time, what do you hope they get from it? And what do you hope they do after hearing a song like that?
Well, for me, I would hope that they would sort of take stock in their life, what they think and how the people around them think and what they can do to sort of, like I said, look in the mirror and make yourself a better person. Because I think if you make yourself a better person, then in turn you make your kids better people, and they go out and make their friends better people. And it's like from your house to your schools, to your community, to your town, to your state, to your country, those things have consequences, and those ripple effects make a difference in people's lives. And I think if one person can get that and spread it to somebody else, then I think that gosh, we've done a decent job.
So Tim, I was watching as I'm, you know, studying up for this, for the hang with you guys. It's rare that you can get two superstars like yourself, unless you're a duo like Florida Georgia Line. So I found this quote that you said, Tim, and I want to know Tyler's reaction to this and kind of get you guys both on this one. But the quote said, getting into the music scene is like getting drunk at midnight, jumping off a cliff and not knowing what's beneath you. And I wonder, Tyler, if you agree with that statement. And then really my base question for this is, what does that mean at the end of the day for you? What is it that is your end goal as you put out songs like this, for instance? Is it awards? Is it number one songs? Is it to find a song like Don't Take the Girl or Cruise that's going to live on for years and years?
Oh, man. First part of the question, yes, I do think getting into the music industry is like jumping off a cliff into a dark hole and you don't know what's underneath you. And for some reason, that excites me a lot. So so that's perfect for me. And yeah, I think ultimately the goal, that's a great question, by the way. I think there's different goals in different seasons. But as I get older, I think the goal is to make music that that makes an impact in our culture and our world and leaves a legacy, something I can be proud of, something my great, great, great grandkids can listen to and say, wow, and get to know me. You know what I'm saying? And I think music has, I don't know, it's a beautiful thing to get to create something out of thin air and basically sit down with the intention of creating something new, and being a creative is just such a gift. And I think it's a gift from God, and I'm extremely grateful and to do it for a living. And, you know, I do think it's important to connect with the fans, to sell tickets, to play stadiums. And I have big dreams and big goals and gotten to do a lot of those dreams, which I'm so thankful for. But when I look at the big picture, I think it's just about making music and doing what we do as artists that impacts the world and makes this world a better place.
That's the beauty and the blessing that we have, like Tyler said, is being creative people and being in this industry and having the opportunity to do that. And the responsibility, I think, in a lot of ways to do that, a responsibility to your art.
Very well said. You guys both broke the internet within a couple of weeks of each other on social media. Tim, you had the picture where you're hanging from a ladder and the Christmas tree. And then Tyler, obviously, you know, you have the unfollow fiasco and the drama that went along with that. When you guys do these things, do you know it's going to go viral? Do you know when you're posting that picture or Tyler, you know, when the unfollow thing happens, you go, well, we're going to have to deal with this tomorrow.
I thought about it the next day and thought, oh, I'm going to have to deal with this. But I literally didn't even think anything about it and thought that I didn't even think that anyone would notice, nor that anyone would care. Clearly, that was not the case. and me and BK are better than we've ever been. And I called him immediately and said, hey, bro, this is what I just saw an article that's saying this and this and this. And I want you to know this is where my heart is, right?
Sure.
And it was fine. It was no big deal. The timing was terrible and it, you know, shouldn't have happened. But ultimately, me and BK are brothers and we love each other. And sometimes social media creates an alternate reality that sometimes is not true. And for me, even with some of my best friends, I'd rather just be with them in reality, in real life, and hang out and know them for the people that I know them to be. And so I got to explain all that to him. And, you know, I think we can all relate to that. It's a funny and scary thing to kind of navigate, but you know, we all try to do our best.
Absolutely. Everybody's trying to do their best and make their best decisions and do the best they can by people, for sure. Mm-hmm.
So Tim, what about you then? Because you have at least one a year. I think the last one before this was you were shirtless holding a fish and the world went nuts. Do you know when the picture's taken, like, all right, this is going to make some noise?
No, I don't. Because I'm not that savvy about it. I don't really, I'm one of the old guys, so I don't really know that much about it. I'll tell you, the thing with the Christmas tree, I just thought it was funny, and I made a joke. I just wanted some evidence that in case my wife was trying to get rid of it by the end of the year for tax purposes. I just wanted to have some evidence.
Guys, thank you so much. Tim McGraw, Tyler Hubbard. The song is called Undivided. We're going to play the heck out of it. Really, I mean, anybody who's listening to this certainly needs to take a moment and listen to it at least a few times through, because it's a song that we need right now. Guys, thank you so much. I appreciate your time.
Heck yeah. Thank you for chatting. Thanks for playing our music and holler at us anytime.
Right on, man. Thank you.